Alright, boy. This is what it's looking like so far. And I noticed some of y'all were saying that the beans aren't creamy until after, or somebody wrote that in. The beans aren't creamy until after I refrigerate them. Reason why is you ain't doing them quite right, boy. What you gotta do, every time you stir them, like you see I'm doing here, smash. Smash them down in the bottom of the pot. And what that's gonna do is break some of them up, and release some of that inside, and it's gonna cream this gravy up a little thicker. So every time you stir, just remember, smash. Stir, smash. You got that, boy? Boy, I hope y'all were paying attention. Look at me when I'm talking to you, boy. I done lost that stick. I ain't gonna say what happened to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and make this rice. And in here, I done put 3 cups of water. So at a 2-to-1 ratio, how much rice you think I ought to use? You can't figure that out. I'm sorry for you. It also calls for a little salt. Here's some salt. Look, salt in the water. Same way with grits. Man, if you don't put salt in first, it ain't gonna taste right. I don't care what kind of rice you're using. So, got a little salt in there. And you just gotta figure, look, it's 2-to-1. If you're gonna use 1 cup of water, use a 1/2 cup of rice. So 3 cups of water, email me if you don't know the answer. Boy. Hey, boy. We're going to make some cornbread. And if you ain't got a cast iron skillet, I say don't even try to do this. Don't even try to do this because it ain't going to fly. Alright? So, on the back of this, this is just plain cornmeal. Plain cornmeal right here. It don't have no nothing in it, so you gotta add stuff. What they talking about is 1 cup of this and 1 cup of flour. If you like a, pay attention. If you like a cake-like cornmeal, then if you like a cake-like cornbread, then you add that much flour. I don't like it cake-like. I like it more cornmeal-like. So we're going to cut the flour down. We ain't trying to build no nuclear submarines, boy. What the world's matter with you? Man, y'all need to pay close attention here. So we're going to add less flour. If you like sugar in it, put sugar. I don't like sugar in mine. So guess what? I ain't put no damn sugar in mine. I just wonder. Let's take a little break here. So this recipe called for a cup of cornmeal and a cup of flour. So what you want to do is change the quantities. So like quantum physics or some crap like that. So if you're going to do that, I'm only going to use 1/2 cup of flour, and I use 1.5 cups of cornmeal. Man, I'm telling y'all the truth. And I'm using self-rising flour, because that's what I got, so I don't have to put the baking powder in there. But I'm going to use the rest of the ingredients. Oh, let's see here. The oven just beeped at me. So I done added a little bit of salt to this. Boy, if you don't put salt in it, you're messing up. It calls for 1/4 cup of oil. So put your motor oil in there now. Not motor oil, boy. Come on, go figure. And what y'all think we're trying to do here? 1 egg cup. I like using that term that I learned from that turkey over there in Florida. milk. Where my milk? Here the milk. And I got the milk that come from them cows that don't take all them steroids and all the other crappy stuff. Alright, so we gonna stir this up and over here, boy. We're gonna stir this up and put it in a well-greased casserole. Now in that you can also put bacon, corn, jalapenos. You can put whatever the hell you want, boy. Main thing you gotta do is put a lot of damn shortening in here, just like you see JB doing. I mean, the more you put, the better this gonna come out. Trust me, boy. All of it. We're gonna bake this off in the oven. Now you can also preheat this before you pour this batter in there. But I ain't do it. How about that? Now I can handle the damn pan. Alright, boy. Pay attention. Over here. Convection oven. It's set on regular bake mode. 450. Put that dog in there and let him hunt.